From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
You're watching News 8 Now. I'm Shannon Moss.
I'm Norm Karkos. Democrats will look to Maine Republican Senators Susan Collins and Olympia Snowe again today to help them pass a $26 billion jobs bill aimed at helping states and school boards deal with budget problems.
Senators Collins and Snowe cashed the key votes to break a Republican-led filibuster yesterday. Senators issued a joint statement saying the money is necessary to help states like Maine protect against further job losses. $26 billion package will provide $16 billion to states to help pay their Medicaid bills and $10 billion for grants to school districts to prevent teacher layoffs. Most Republicans opposed the measure, saying it would make states more dependent on federal funds.
Lawmakers in Augusta say if the bill does not pass, the state will face a $100 million budget hole this fiscal year. Now, it's projected that our state will get about $77 million in increased Medicaid funding under that bill. The legislation would also provide an additional $39 million to protect teaching jobs here as well. Governor John Baldacci says this legislation will help Maine recover from the recession and will mean better health care and a stronger education system.
Thanks to a strong Canadian dollar right now, a lot of tourists from Canada are heading south and filling Maine beaches this summer. Old Orchard Beach was packed yesterday. Many of those people are from Canada. While Canadians have been flocking there for decades, tourism officials say they've seen a recent spike, and they now say as many as 60% of the tourists are from Canada because their dollar is worth a couple cents more than ours. And another contributing factor, it's a national holiday in Canada.
But the past 2 weeks, there is a big holiday in Quebec, which a lot of people are involved in the construction industry are on holidays, so you probably get more people at that time. But, you know, the exchange rate's good, the weather is great for the summer, you got some great beaches here too, so it's hard to resist.
And it's not just the beaches seeing the boom from Canada. The outlets in Kittery parking lots were packed, and most of the license plates we saw were from Canada.
Well, golfers from the Portland area can get a great deal on the next round on the links. Nunsuch River Golf Club in Scarborough is offering a discount to anyone who donates a non-perishable food item. Everything they collect goes to the new Good Shepherd Food Bank Center in Portland, which just opened last month. Well, the offer is quite simple. For the next 3 weeks, anyone who donates food gets a round of golf with a cart for $35. That's a savings of $16.
Good deal.
I just thought it was a good way to give something back on a daily basis every day, and it's kind of a win-win where, you know, people can play here if they bring some food for this great cause, and they can play for less money, and so everybody wins.
The offer is good all day, Monday through Thursday, and in the afternoon on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. And while they will accept any non-perishable foods, the priority is protein items such as canned tuna or chicken. All right, thousands of people are celebrating one of Maine's most famous foods this week. Of course, that's the lobster.
Get out those bibs. Maine Lobster Festival kicked off yesterday in Rockland. Organizers say the festival usually draws between 50 and 60,000 people. They have more than 20,000 pounds of lobster on hand. Maine Lobster Festival runs until Sunday evening. To learn more about the festival, all you have to do is go to the As Seen On section of our website, WMTW.com.
That's it for this update. I'm Norm Karkos.
And I'm Shannon Moss. Stay with us for your forecasts and sports highlights. They're coming up. We'll be right back.